Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. And if you're new, what up? So today we are going to be testing out the new Colourpop Lux glosses that came out, and I feel like everybody and their mom ran to the website to order these glosses when they first released, because these went out of stock so damn fast. I had to go ahead and place another order to get the ones that I wanted. I got 4 out of the 8 because these were the ones that I was pretty interested in, but I'm probably gonna end up picking up the rest of the shades just because I want to try them all out. So this is what the packaging of the gloss looks like, and then this is what the actual lip gloss looks like. So it's a nice little chubby size. It definitely reminds me of some other lip glosses out there on the market, but this is the packaging for it. And these glosses retail for $8, and they currently have 8 shades of these glosses, and they range from being super super opaque and just a cream finish to being more of a glittery type of finish. So you get a little bit more of that glittery type of shine to your lips. So I ordered 3 more cream type of finishes, and then one has the glittery type of finishes, and I ordered them in tones that I felt like would be flattering for my skin tone. Of course, I just wanted to go ahead and try them out in tones that, you know, would flatter me a little bit more, and then go ahead and pick up the other ones if I felt the need to. So today I'm going to be trying on all these colors, and then I have one little itty bitty dupe to show you guys. But I already know that people have done dupe videos for these who received the whole collection. They've done dupe videos for these glosses because some of these glosses are dupes for other higher end glosses out there. So yeah, I'm just gonna be trying these on. So if you guys wanna see that, then just keep on watching. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and take off my current lip color. So I am exfoliating my lips using the ColourPop Lippy Scrub, just because I feel like it's super important to exfoliate your lips even when you're wearing a gloss, just so they glide on super, super smooth and don't sink down into the cracks of your lips. So lips are all exfoliated. I still have a little bit of glitter and shimmer from the lip gloss that I was wearing, but I feel like it'll be okay. So the first gloss I'm gonna go in with is Slow Motion, which this is the packaging, and then this is the actual gloss. And I feel like Slow Motion is a little bit of a mauvey brown type of tone. And it definitely has some color to it. So I zoomed you guys in a little bit. So this is the shade Slow Motion. So it has a lot of color to it. It's not a super duper sheer type of gloss. It is a little bit more opaque, and I think that you can get away with using this just on its own without having a lip liner or a lip stick underneath of it. I wish this was a little bit more glossy. It's cute or whatever, but I just wish it was a little bit more glossy. But that is how it looks with just one layer for both my top and bottom lips. So again, this is the shade Slow Motion. So the next one I have to show you guys is Come Through, and this one is actually a dupe for the Fenty gloss in Fenty Glow, the original gloss balm. So I'm gonna swatch my Fenty gloss balm on my arm, and then I'm gonna swatch this one right next to it. So this is Fenty Glow, and then that one is Come Through from ColourPop. So essentially they are kind of the same. I would say that Come Through from ColourPop is just a little bit darker, but on the lips they're gonna look the same. So I'm gonna go ahead and apply Come Through. Okay, so this is what Come Through looks like. So Come Through is a little bit more sheer than the other one, and I feel like my lips are looking pretty pigmented right now just because I keep applying and reapplying lip products. So they're showing up a little bit more reddish pink than they normally would. But this is what Come Through looks like, and this is essentially what my lips look like whenever I apply the Fenty Glow gloss balm to my lips. So I'm actually gonna go ahead, since you guys know what this color looks like on my lips, I'm actually gonna go ahead and apply my Fenty gloss balm right on top of it so you guys can see. So So it looks exactly the same. I just feel like the Fenty has a little bit more shimmer to it and it's a lot more glossy, and I will talk about that at the end when I give you guys my actual review of these products. But don't my lips look nice and big and juicy? They look so good. Like, yo, somebody need to come and kiss me right now. So the next shade I have to show you guys is Overnight. And Overnight is more of like a peachy nude type of color. So this is what the actual gloss looks like. So this one is lighter than all of the other ones. So like I said, Overnight is lighter than all of the other ones, but I do really, really like this color, especially over my natural lip color. But this is one that I probably would definitely wear with a lip liner or over top of a lipstick to give it a little bit something more, but it's still a super gorgeous color. I still really like this one, and I knew that I would really like this one since it's more of that peachy type of nude. I think it's so pretty. So this is the shade Overnight. So the last one I have for you guys is called Dream Queen, which looks like this. And Dream Queen is basically more of a pinky, darker type of shade. So I'm gonna go ahead and apply that one. So this is Dream Queen. Again, this is one that I really like over top of my natural skin color. I feel like it looks really nice. This is another one that I would just wear on its own because I feel like it gives enough juiciness to my lips. It makes my lips look just like a my lips but better type of color. I feel like this one just looks really nice over top of my natural lip color. I don't need a lip liner with it or anything like that. So I really like this one. So right now I'm just going to go ahead and apply Come Through over top of this one. Just because I really like the Come Through shade a little bit more and the fact that it has some shimmer in it. Yeah, I think that is really pretty. I think my lips look nice and juicy. So yeah, I'm going to zoom you guys out so we can talk about these new Luxe lip glosses from ColourPop. Alright you guys, so how do I feel about the new Luxe glosses from ColourPop after trying on all four shades for you guys? I have worn Come Through for a few hours before I did this video. So I do have some pros and cons for this lip gloss. Okay, so my first pro is going to be that the shades are really, really pretty. And I like the fact that they have a little bit of color to them. And they're not super, super sheer. So they do give a little bit of color to your lips. And if you have lighter colored lips, I feel like a lot of these are going to show up really, really well on your skin. So I like the colors. I also like the color selection because I feel like it ranges from a nice light shade to a nice darker shade. So everybody, literally every skin tone can find some glosses in this collection that they really, really like, and that's gonna flatter their skin tone. And then I also like that you can mix and match them. So just like how the last one I tried on was Dream Queen, and I went ahead and I put Come Through over the top of it since I wanted a little bit more shimmer to it. I feel like you can layer these and like customize your own color or your own finish or whatever the case may be. So I just think the colors in this collection are really, really pretty. Since they only came out with 8 colors, I feel like they did a really good job of the actual color range. So another pro of this lip gloss would be the packaging. Of course, the packaging is super, super cute. I love the big doe foot applicator. Everyone loves a big doe foot applicator for lip gloss, for concealer. It just works really, really well at covering a nice amount of the area, and it just like glides on super easily. The applicator is nice and soft, so I definitely like the packaging of these. Another one would be the smell. So this is a different type of smell. It does not smell like the Fenty Gloss Balm at all. I feel like the Fenty Gloss Balm smells more like candy. It's a fruity type of artificial candy, but these smell more like a citrus vanilla type of scent. It's different than any other type of lip gloss I've ever smelled before. So they went in a different direction with the scent, but I actually really like it. I don't mind having scents in my lip products. I just enjoy it every time I use it. So definitely a pro would be the scent. So I do have some cons with these lip glosses. And the first con would be if you layer these too much, they can get goopy really, really fast. And I feel like that is a flaw in the formula of it. So these are definitely more cream filling than they are glossy. So that makes them a lot thicker than like a traditional lip gloss usually is. So comparing it to the Fenty Gloss Bomb, to me, the Fenty Gloss Bomb is one of the most amazing lip glosses that I've ever used in my life because it's so slick feeling. It almost feels like wet on the lips. It doesn't feel like a lip gloss. It's so slick. It's not at all sticky. I mean, like I can pop my lips and it doesn't feel like anything. It's not sticky at all. And it just feels so good and hydrating on the lips. As far as these Luxe glosses, I don't necessarily feel as though they're hydrating. They might be hydrating, but I just don't feel that when I first apply them. I don't know, they feel a little bit thick and I can just tell that they can start gooping up. One, if you put too much on, and then once they start to wear away, you're definitely gonna get that like goopy line in the center of your lips. And like I said, that's just a flaw in the formula. I feel like this is more of a creamy thick type of formula as opposed to it being really slick like the Fenty Gloss Bomb. So yeah, that's my con. And then another con I would say would be that they aren't as glossy and juicy as I would like. I was hoping that these would be super glossy, like they're so juicy lip glosses. Those are my favorite. When I want that super glossy, pouty, like my lips just got injected type of look, those are the glosses that I use. I don't know if it's because they really have some plumping properties in it or if it's just because they're so glossy and shiny, but those really make your lips look super juicy and just like I said, like you just got them injected. But these, on the other hand, they're not as glossy. Like they are a gloss. You can definitely tell that you have something shiny on your lips, but I just feel like they aren't as glossy. And I feel like that compared to the Fenty Gloss Bomb, it's not as glossy. So even though Come Through is a dupe for the Fenty Gloss Bomb, it's not a dupe as far as formula wise or as far as how juicy and glossy it makes your lips look. But the color is similar, as well as the shimmer that's inside of it is very, very, very similar. So yeah, those are my pros and cons of the ColourPop Lux glosses. Does that mean that I'm not gonna use these? Does that mean I'm not gonna buy more? No, I probably will buy more. I do really love ColourPop's products and I do really like how they're trying to be innovative and they're trying to come out with a lot of different things to suit a lot of different people. So with that being said, I'm definitely gonna rock these glosses by themselves over top of lipsticks, over top of lip liners. I do still think they are really, really nice. So that is it for this video, you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed seeing my review of the ColourPop Lux glosses. If you liked it, then go ahead and give it a big thumbs up, as well as leave me a comment down below letting me know if you've tried these or if you're gonna buy them. Whatever the case may be, just leave it in the comments down below. If you are new, definitely hit that subscribe button as well as the bell notification so that you are notified every single time that I upload a video. And I will see y'all in my next one. Peace.